CNN can now confirm that John and Elizabeth Edwards have legally separated. Let's talk a little bit about the timing on this. First, you remember all the denials, John Edwards denying for months that he'd fathered a child out of wedlock. Let's listen to just a sampling of that first.
Talk about these tabloids and their tabloid trash is full of lies.
I don't respond to these lies.
Well, no more denials, obviously. Last week, Edwards finally came clean. Here's another important part of the timeline. Next week comes the tell-all book from the former confidant who helped Edwards conceal his affair with the videographer, Rial Hunter. And now comes word of this legal separation through a source close to Edwards, close to Elizabeth Edwards, I should say. Joining me now from New York is David Kaplan, senior editor of People magazine. People originally broke the story on the Edwards separation. Well, I guess, take us through this. What do you know? What happened to suddenly make this become a separation?
Well, Elizabeth and John separated shortly after Christmas, and it was actually after a friend of theirs tells People that they really had a nice Christmas together with their kids, but they separated then. John is living actually at a part of their home in North Carolina called what they refer to as the Annex. He's living there as well as a beach house about 160 miles away from where Elizabeth is. She's remaining in Chapel Hill right now.
What about all the stories we heard in the past? I mean, were they not true? Didn't they try to put things back together as a married couple?
Yeah, you know, they definitely were trying. They were trying to sort of, you know, make it work for themselves and for their kids. You know, however, sources tell People in our current issue that really Elizabeth, she just became really too mistrustful. It wasn't something that she could continue doing. And as well, on the flip side, they say actually that John really sort of got tired of almost really being on his tippy toes. He didn't want to have to feel that Elizabeth, say, would be looking at his cell phone to see who, you know, he was calling and all that sort of stuff.
So what happens to the mistress? Boy, it's almost uncomfortable talking
about Hunter.
Yeah, what happens to Rial Hunter and the child that he, I can say, had with Rial Hunter, right?
Yep. Right now, they're actually living in a home in Charlotte, North Carolina. John bought the house. It was a little bit over $500,000. Interestingly enough, John actually went house hunting, really, with Elizabeth. They got this house. John does not have any direct contact with Rial. He deals with an intermediary.
Wait a minute. I just heard you say something. Take me back there. He went house hunting with his wife for
I thought you'd find that interesting, Rick.
for a home where he would put
for the
his
other woman,
mistress
you're right.
And his child? Did you just say
exactly.
That?
Exactly. Wow. I did say that. I know, it's unbelievable. You sort of say it, some people are like, huh? But they did. They, you know, Elizabeth, she went on sort of, you know, the house hunt with John. They, you know, he bought this house, and it was, you know, I think $530,000 or so for something like that in Charlotte.
And
so
who's going to live there?
It's a testament.
Who's going to live
this
there?
This is what Rial's going to live. Rial's going to live there with Quinn. I mean, it's really a testament, I think, to Elizabeth's character that she did this, to be honest with you.